In this video, let's create some scripts to hide and unhide bunch of worksheets really quickly. So usually hiding, unhiding worksheets is not really a big deal. So if you want to hide one, you can just right click on this and do a hide sheet that will hide that worksheet. If you want to unhide it, you open this and it's gonna show up here, see grayed out. I'm gonna click on it and it's gonna unhide it. So if you didn't know, now you know. Now, the problem that we're trying to fix today is when you have many of these. And then you need to hide a bunch of them and then unhide. How do you do something like that? So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna first create another worksheet. I'm gonna call this one Sheet Manager. And what I'm gonna do on this one, I'm basically first gonna get a nice list of all worksheets we have in the spreadsheets here. So let's just do something like sheet names. And we need those listed here. And we're gonna do that with a script. So we'll go under Tools and Script Editor. Let's name this project. So let's start by a function that's just gonna list our worksheets here. So I'm just gonna call this getListOfSheets. And here what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna first get my spreadsheet to a variable. So we'll take our spreadsheet app and do getActiveSpreadsheet. Then I need a reference to this sheet manager worksheet that I just named here. So I'm gonna say WS manager equals, and then I'm gonna take that SS variable and do get sheet by name and paste that sheet manager name here. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna go to my spreadsheet, and here we have this get sheets method, which basically gets an array of worksheets. Let's just save that in a variable again. So now because this is an array, we should be able to loop through that array and get all the names of our worksheets. And then hopefully we'll plug that information in this worksheet manager. So let's first get a list of names. So for that, I'll take the sheets variable and map. Since it's an array, we should be able to map it to a new array with some new results. And here I'm gonna do a callback function. So for each sheet in this array, we're gonna do a callback function. I'll do arrow function here. And what we're gonna do, we're just gonna return that sheet.get, is it name or sheet name? Let's see. It's probably name, but let's see if there is a sheet. There is a sheet name, so let's use that. So that's just gonna give us the name of the worksheet. It's gonna return that, and we're gonna map it to a new array here. I'm just gonna call it sheet names. So right now, just to show you what we have in the sheet names, I'm just gonna do a console log for the time being. Let's save and run this getListOfSheets function right here. I'm gonna click run. We're gonna have to deal with all the permission stuff. And now as you can see, what I got is an array of worksheets. Now I want to take this list basically and put it right here. And for that, I need this to be in a form of array of arrays, because it's a worksheet, we need to have a row column structure, which right now we don't have. So for that reason, I'm gonna go back to this, and instead of returning that as a single element, I'm gonna return that as an array in square brackets. And if I do this and run this, you'll see now each one has its own array. So basically it's a column row structure now. So that means now we should be able to take that and put it in this worksheet manager sheet. So I'm gonna take that WS manager. In that worksheet, we're gonna get the range. So we need to start from the second row, first column. The reason for that, see, it's gonna start from here, second row, and it's in the first column. And then we need to provide the number of rows. It's gonna be the number of sheets. So we'll do this dot length. And then the number of columns, I guess we'll just take the first column from this list. We could just say one, but just to make sure in case we update something later, let's just do it this way. I'm gonna take the first row and count how many things we have in it. So it's gonna give us the number of columns. So that should give us a range. Now to do information in that range of cells, we need to do set values, and as values we'll pass this array of sheet names. So at this point, if I run this script, if I go back to my spreadsheet, see we have a list of worksheets all listed here, including this one. I'm gonna probably move the sheet manager a little bit to the left. And now if I go back and rerun this, you should see it should update this. So far I was able to get a list of worksheets. Now what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna do another column of checkboxes where I'm gonna choose whether that should be hidden or not hidden. Let's just call it hidden. And basically we'll just select this whole area. I'm just gonna do Command Shift down and go under Insert and do Checkbox. So now we have a bunch of checkboxes here. So the logic is gonna be, we could just come in here and select, let's hide this, whatever. And then as we click something, it should just hide those worksheets and it should also display the ones that are not checked. So for that, we're gonna do a separate function here. So we'll do a function, we're gonna call it show hide sheets. And again, we're gonna start by getting these two things. We'll get the current spreadsheet, we'll get that sheet manager worksheet, this one. Then I want to get this data from here, this worksheet names and basically checkboxes here. So to do that, I'm gonna take that WS manager worksheet and I'm gonna do get range. And I'll just do it like a regular Excel range. I'll do A to B all the way down. So I'm gonna say A to colon B. And then we'll do get values to actually get those values from those two columns. I'm gonna go ahead and save that in a variable here. We'll just call this WS manager data. So let's just do a quick console log of this data to see what's in it, and we'll go from there. So I'm gonna take this WS manager data and console log that. Now we need to run this function. And as you can see, I get all of these falses, and then some of them are trues, which are our checked boxes. But I also get all those empty rows down here. So first I wanna make sure I clear those. So I only want to just get this part where I actually have some worksheet names. And for that, we should be able to just take whatever that list of values is. Let's just pass this to the next line. And do dot filter to filter those results. And again, I'm just gonna pass this to the next line so it's easier to read. And here for each row in that array, we're going to run a filter, and I wanna make sure that the first column is not blank. I'm gonna save this and rerun this so you can see what happens. So now you can see those empty ones are gone. Now I only get this list of worksheets and true and false values right here. So basically the idea is gonna be, now I need to loop through this, and if that says true, I need to make sure that I basically make that worksheet hidden, and if it's false, I have to make that worksheet visible. So what I'll do, I'll go right here, and we'll have this WS manager thing, and I'm gonna loop through that WS manager data. So I'll just do a for each loop, and for each line, I guess, I'll just call that. It's a variable name. We're gonna do some magic here. And what we need to do for each line inside of that data set, let's bring this back. So for each line here, I wanna make sure that I go grab the worksheet with this name. And then if this says false, I wanna make sure I make it visible. Or the other way around, if it says true, invisible. So I'll take my spreadsheet and do get sheet by name. And I'm gonna get that name from the first column from those results. So that will be from my line, the first column, 0. So that should get me the worksheet. So I'm just gonna put this in a variable. And then in that worksheet, that doesn't seem to give me the right autocomplete for some reason. So probably because I did a mistype here. So this should be get sheet by name, not name. There it is. So now let's see if we get the autocomplete. We do. So now for each worksheet here, see if I scroll down, there's this method hide sheet. And then if I keep looking, see there's also the opposite. Let's just do one of them. I'm going to say, if the line 1, which is the second column in this data right here, if this is true, then I want to hide the worksheet. So I'll take the worksheet and do a hide sheet. And otherwise, we'll just do this. Just a one-liner here. So let's just save this and see what happens and take it from here. So I have this function now. Let's go and see these are checked now. So everything that's checked should be set to hidden if I run this function. So let's go and run this. So let's go back and check what happened. So sheet 5, 6, and 7. See, doesn't seem like they're here anymore, but they should be here under hidden, see? Now let's hide more stuff. I'm just gonna hide a bunch of this regular ones. Let's just only keep 22 and one more and these three. Let's actually also do this one. So let's go back and rerun this thing. Show hide sheets. Go back and take a look. See, those four are left. The rest are now hidden. Just for testing that it unhides too, let's bring back this start here. So if I go back, see start here is back. So there's one last thing I want to do here. I want to update the previous function I did, this one, that gets my list of sheets. And preferably, when I update it, I want to also update the status, whether it's hidden or not. As of right now, if I make some changes here and run it, it's gonna update this list, but these checkboxes are just gonna stay as they are. So let's see if we can do that. So I'm gonna go back. So right here, when we list the worksheet name, as a second column here, I want to also get whether that worksheet is hidden or not. And for that, I'm just going to do a comma here to add a second column. And I'm going to say sheet for each sheet. And here for each sheet, we should have this function isSheetHidden. So that should basically give us true or not. So if it's hidden, it should bring back true, which is going to be excellent because hidden ones are checkboxes that are trues and the rest should be false. So let's just save this, go back and try to rerun this thing. Mess around with this checkboxes a little bit. And then let's go back and run this get list of sheets. Let's see if it updated this. So as you can see, we got it updated nicely. It lists what's hidden, what's not. And finally, to make this user friendly, let's just make a couple of buttons here. So that's one. Let's do another one. Move it here. And at this point, I'm just going to go grab this get list of sheets function name. Go back here. And for this one, I'm going to click on this assign script, paste it here, and then I'll go back and grab my second function, copy it, go back, click on this and assign script, paste on this. And now we should have two buttons here. So now if I wanted to unhide a bunch of sheets, I should be able to just check these boxes, click on this. And then if I change some of these, then I can go back to my sheet manager and just click update worksheet list and see it should just get me all that information and also what's hidden, what's not. And then I should be able to just hide whatever I want. So let's just hide everything other than the sheet manager. Hide on hide. And there you go. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.